Councilman Zarks, any discussion?
Yes. Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
I mean, I don't know why we're going over this again this year. I thought it was very well done last year through the survey that our parents and teachers took, that we presented, and it was 51 or 52% wants the 2 weeks to come off for it. That's a good majority of it, so I don't know why we're discussing this again this year. 39%, only 39% went to 1 week for it. And then there was another item that put in there, going to start after Labor Day. I don't know why that was put in there other than to maybe confuse the issue. The bottom line is, our parents, our teachers, 52% at 2 weeks. Why do we have to discuss this every year?
My sentiment, my responses to these folks is, look, I want to support
is the state assessments that we have to hold to, and we have to perform at district level. And our high schools are placed in a significant burden because we are on a block schedule. And when high school students are out for that time period, they're missing more school than they would be on a 7-day period type of schedule. So my caveat is, if we remain 2 weeks for this year, next year, 3 years, or however long, we have to look at alternatives so that the teachers who bear the burden of the EOCs at the end of the year and each semester, for all the other teachers within that school who bear the burden of that score for their evaluations, that we have to look at other alternatives to make sure that these teachers can face those students. Because I can see the argument from elementary school or middle schools that it is a significant benefit for a lot of those, for a lot of those teachers. I can definitely assure you that. I've got four little ones at home right now. But my concern is, like I said, the teachers perceived this fall break, which for a lot of them perceived as actual. And trying to pace our students at the high school level so that those teachers who place and have that burden aren't overwhelmed with that type of stress, because we see it.
I do hear the argument about the high schools and testing, but also see reports from this very office that our ACT scores continue to rise from our high school. So I don't know if that's a legitimate argument or not.
Well, and Mr. McNeese, I don't speak that. We are very proud of our ACT scores, but that is a completely different test and assessment from what the state requires us on the EOCs. And 1/3 of your high school teachers carry that burden because they're in the testing areas where 2/3 are not in that contested. Regardless, that is what and how that school is reflected on state assessments. And that's not something that we can, you know, step out and say that we're not going to be a participant, even though we are looking at some of the alternatives that we're going to take for the state. But be that as it may, that we are still obligated to make sure that our schools assess well. And again, I know that that's also something that has been shared with me, that we need to get out from under that and not hold our schools accountable. And because the teachers are stressed, our students are stressed, and I don't dispute that. But again, we, as a block schedule, that 3 weeks after we come off fall break, our kids are being assessed on state EOCs. And that's not a middle school or elementary. They get that at the end of the year, but our high schools are assessed twice, at the end of fall break and at the end of spring break.
I hear your point, Dr. Wright. However, if I'm going to base what our school system does on how the state conduct is their test, you may worry, they're terrible. The other thing, our high schools have a 5-star rating. Is that correct?
Yes, sir, for us, they get a 5. Yes, sir, they did. And that's absolutely astounding.
It is outstanding, and it's because of our teachers.
And I don't dispute that either.
You know, we sit up here.
We have excellent teachers.
Better than excellent, if I can believe. We sit up here and think we do a lot as a school board. We should only deal with policy and budgetary things. Our teachers are what make our county. Nobody up here in this central office, nobody on this sitting on this board, it's our teachers that drive our county. And to me, we need to listen to what they want. Our EOC run by the state is a joke.
But we're still held accountable.
Yep, and they're still a joke, so why would I want to base on what I want to do on what the state does? And I know I'm preaching a losing battle here, but I gotta say it.
Ma'am,
I've got a quote.
I'm not,
you
harder time with this kind of schedule, with the out of school one week. And I've got a certain here, so I feel like I've got a little input in this thing and observation. You might disagree, but I'm. And that second week was put in when the clock schedule was put in for remediation. Not for vacation, not for whatever, it was put in for remediation. And after that went on the wayside, the remediation, I think, you know, it was hard to help children who were having difficulty or had issues. And when that came off the plate, I feel like it's a difficult thing for them to restart them and get them back to where they need to be. That is my opinion.
I want to speak just to get this on the record. I appreciate all those who called me. I know this is going to be a tough thing. There are a lot of mayors, a lot of people out there who support the two-week break. And I have talked to everybody. I've talked to a lot of people. I still get calls and emails. And I appreciate that interest. I'd like to see that interest in other issues, such as teacher pay, such as the sales tax funding and other things. I'd like to see us get that passion about other things. And I don't even believe this, they're more important than the county. I'm doing exactly what I didn't want to do when I got elected. I said I'd worry about funding, growth, and overall direction of the school system. And I've spent all weekend talking about high school names and calendars. I'm going to try to echo where I am on this calendar, and I've listened to a lot of people in the 2 weeks. First, it was a survey, not a vote. And it was 52% to 39%. It's a majority, but it's not a landslide, and so we need to dig a little deeper. Most of the reasons given for 2 weeks were better vacations, more family time. Children are stressed out and need that time to recover. And it's easier on joint custody families, and I understand that. That's I truly understand that if there's a difficult custody relationship. But I think we're putting a handle on things. If our children are truly stressed out after 9 weeks from doing something wrong, whether it's through testing, whether it's through unrealistic expectations, learning should be fun and kids should not be stressed out. So let's not do a band-aid of 2 weeks. Let's figure out why they're being stressed out and fix that so kids actually have fun learning and have a week to kind of relax and come back. With regard to 1 week, there are 146 school districts in Tennessee. I think only four have a 2 week break. In going to the TSBA this weekend, it really echoed on me that, especially more so in high school, but school in general, high school is supposed to prepare our students for college or work. And they want the students to have those skills. They want us to have communication skills. They want us to have math skills. They want us to have other technology skills. They also want us to have life skills and soft skills. And some of those are attendance. And the fact that none of those things in college or work, you get a 2 week break. You're used to working through. You might get a 1 week break, or a few people get a long 2 week vacation. Most importantly, I believe there's a learning drop on a longer break. 1 week refocuses people, 2 weeks reduces focus. And I say learning, I'm not talking about testing, I'm talking about learning. Learning is sequential, and it builds on itself. And we only have so many days, we just talked about reports and stockpile days. We want to get the value out of those days for the child and the teacher. We don't want wasted days. And so when you wait a long time, I believe that you lose a couple days for review. Also think during Thanksgiving in those 2 days, nothing productive gets done. It's just kind of a review day or massive day. The other thing for some people that are for the 1 week, there are a lot of families where finding 2 weeks of child care in a row is very difficult. There's a lot of low-income families, and they can call in favors, and they can find, you know, they can go on vacation for a week. But there's a lot of people that they end up having one parent has to take off 1 week, and the other parent has to take off the other week to watch their children, and they can't go anywhere, where if it's 1 week, they can take off at the same time. Also, there's 2,500 children in Wilson County who are in the backpack program. A lot of those kids, the only real meal sustenance they get is coming to school for meals, for lunch and breakfast. And we have a backpack program. A lot of people try to take care of those kids, but going a week is hard, but then going 2 weeks is even harder than we go through. And then, there's a little bit of just scheduling issues with sports and clubs having a difficulty on break when you're competing with other counties that don't have that long sustained break. And so kids who are in a club don't really get to go on break anywhere because there's practices all the way through. And then, again, as Mr. Robinson said, the original purpose was no longer valid. It was a two-week training for retention and instruction, and it kind of a tutoring. And we do a better job on that because we do it daily. And so that's kind of where we're at. And so all those are just some of the reasons and where my mind is on this vote and why I support the county.
An amazing thing is happening right now. I'm getting messages from people asking why I voted against the calendar, which is fascinating. Let's get a vote. But I expected that because people just don't seem to want to believe me anymore. I inherently, easily cannot support this recommendation because of the promise I've made to teachers that I've worked very hard for this past summer and continue to work for because I see the need. I've had a handful of teachers tell me that they could see a change in benefit. Simply put, the number of teachers that I've, and not that I'm dismissing parents at all, but my heart lies with the teachers in this scenario. And so, for the record, I will not be supporting this recommendation for a one split week calendar.
And I understand that, Mr. Saul.
I know you know that.
And I would like to say that I appreciate the many, many emails that I have received from you requesting very respectfully for you to consider this. And I have very deeply considered this and tried to read all the emails.
Things we hear from,
everybody has those children that, those instances where it is a problem. Somebody mentioned other, we're one of the only schools that have block schedules and two-week break. Well, I'm looking at our scores. I think other schools need to get what we do here in Wilson County. I mean, we keep going up. And the last thing maybe I'll comment on, we worry about these children that don't eat. We don't seem to worry about them during Christmas or summer break, only when it's convenient for us to have an excuse for this particular thing.
Any other discussion? I'd just like to say that I don't think there's anybody that would like to say our calendar reduced or shortened any more than I would. And we need to find ways to try to do that, whatever it might be. As long as we're taking breaks, all these holidays that we're getting, and everything that we're required to go to school 180 days, so. Had someone tell me today that Sumter County starts before we do, and, I mean after we do, and they get out before we do. And I called a friend of mine, a principal over there. She told me that that wasn't necessarily right. They have to get one week in the spring and one week in the fall. Well, so I knew that, but so you know, there's a lot of things out there. You got to. Folks sitting up here behind this table have got to make a decision of what they feel is the best interest of the school system. And that's what we're elected to do. Sometimes those are not possible. They're not popular decisions. Not popular at all. But you got to make a decision. You got to what you feel like is the best interest. And you have to base those decisions on what you get from the people that you have working for you. They're supposed to know what they're doing. And, that are telling you and giving you this information. Now, am I supposed to sit back and question everything that they ask me and try to find some kind of fault with it and say that it's not true and that's not facts? And you know, you look at it and you want to take it to be the truth and find out if it is the truth. And you know, I hear this, you know, I have a daughter who teaches. I hear it every day from her, what, you know, the stress that we honor and everything else. Got kids that wouldn't got, let's see, what about that? Got some men here. I got two directors in school right now. But, you know, and I know, you know, how they do. But I've got to make the decision, and I feel like it's the best interest of everyone, not just a few. So, any other discussion this time? If not, I assume we're ready to vote. And I think the motion was that we accept the recommendation of the director of school to have 1 week in October, 1 week in Thanksgiving, and have 3 days added at the end of the calendar that we would be excused from the school on May 20th. Is that correct?
We would end the school year 3 days earlier.
3 days earlier. That was one question that I've heard several times in the last few days. What are you doing with those extra 3 days? No, you're not taking them away from them. We're very added in the calendar so we get out of school 3 days to meet.
Yes, sir.
All right. Being no further discussion, all in favor of the recommendation of 1 October, 1 Thanksgiving, and 3 days added at the end of the school system vote yes, and those opposed, so they vote no. Let it show that it passes 4-3.
You got there.